Hello students, now we are completed already that all the ratio calculation and all the theory part of the admission of a partner. Now we are starting the goodwill and goodwill treatment, its treatment in the account. So first start with the goodwill meaning goodwill is the value of good name. Goodwill means here value of the good name or reputation of the business which attracts more customers and helps the firm to earn more profit. When your firm is attracts the more customers, no, then automatically your profit should be earn more there. That is called as a goodwill here. Nim business yavaga nimdu hesaru galisthiti mat hecha profit earn maadidithala adukke enante aa situation niva goodwill niv create maadidira anta heltare. Goodwill anna reputation na create maadidire nim business dalli anta helbekagutte. So goodwill is the value of good name or reputation of the business which attracts, that goodwill attracts more customers and helps the firm to earn more profit. This is the meaning of goodwill. So next, factors affecting the goodwill. Factors affecting the goodwill here. First one, nature of product. Nature of product means on which type of you are producing your product, no? On that base only your goodwill is based there. So your product should be there good, your goodwill also increase there. So it is a nature of product. Location of the business, in which place you are locating your business, so that is also depends the your goodwill. So that is location of business. Then efficiency of management. Efficiency means here you learned in the business study, you may learned in the business study that efficiency means doing the task or completing the task in minimum cost or minimum time, in within a minimum time here. Efficiency of management, so this is also creates your goodwill in the firm. Then earning capacity of the business, earning capacity of the business, profit earning capacity of the business here. Then past profits of the business, earlier year profits also depends here on the goodwill. These are the factors affecting the goodwill. Next one, definition of goodwill. Definition, Magee defines goodwill as the capacity of the business to earn more profits in future is basically what is meant by the term goodwill. It means that Magee defines that goodwill here, the capacity of the business to earn more profit in the future days. This is a different definition. Next one, valuation of goodwill comes here. Valuation of goodwill. Valuation andre eno kandidiyodu matha treatment madododanne accounts alli entry madodu. So valuation of goodwill, need for valuation. Yadak bek nimge, why you need the valuation of goodwill here? Normally the need for valuation of goodwill arises at the time of sale of business. Normally valuation of goodwill arises at the time of sale of business only, but in the case of partnership also, but at the time of partnership it may also arise the following circumstances. In the following circumstances, partnership dalli ill kele kottinanta circumstances dalaga ni valuation madlikke bekaagutide, necessary there. So first one, admission of a partner. Admission of partner, in the time of admission you should calculate the goodwill of the your firm and admit the your new partner. Next one, retirement of partner. At the time of retirement of a partner, you should also calculate the value of the goodwill and their part of their share to retired person, that should be given there. Then death of a partner, at the time of death of partner in a partnership firm. And then change in the profit sharing ratio, dissolution of partnership firm and amalgamation. Amalgamation means here it is a one type of partnership reconstitution. It is the internal reconstitution of the partnership here. So amalgamation, these are the circumstances when you need the valuation of goodwill in the part. Next here, methods of valuation of goodwill. Valuation of methods are the methods are only, sorry, valuation of goodwill in that methods, three methods are there. First one, average profit method. Second one, super profit method and capitalization method. First you taken average profit method. Under this method, the given number of years of profit and losses are averaged, and the average profit is multiplied with the agreed number of years of purchases to ascertain the goodwill. In this sentence is how you calculate the goodwill, no? That much only you get given there. How it is? The given number of years of profits and losses, that should be averaged year, and that average profit is multiplied with the number of years of purchases to calculate the goodwill here. So goodwill equals to average profit into number of years of purchases. Formula of the goodwill calculation is that goodwill equals to average profit into number of years of purchases. In this method, average profit you have to calculate. You have to be calculate in this one. And number of years of purchase they may give in the problem. So, in the average profit method, they also classified with the two methods. That is simple average profit method and weighted average profit method. Simple average and weighted average. First one we are taking here, simple average profit method. Simple here, problem number one. Goodwill of the firm is valued at 3 years of purchases. Here, in the formula years of purchases there now, that should be mentioned here, 3 years of purchases. Of the average profit of last 4 years, the profits and losses of the last 4 years were given as below here. So, year 2013 to 14, rupees 6,000 profit. 2014-15, 2,000 loss is arising there. 2015-16, again they earn profit 10,000. 2016-17, 12,000 they earn the profit here. So, only method is that, first you calculate the average profit. After that, yeah, that average profit into 3 years of purchase should be multiplied there to calculate the goodwill. Two steps are coming here. First to average profit calculation and second to goodwill valuation or calculation of goodwill. Question is that calculate the goodwill of the firm under average profit method. Under simple average profit method here or also average profit method. So let's start the solution of the goodwill valuation. So first you should find out the average profit. How it should be find out here? First you calculate average profit. Profit equals to how it is should be calculated, total profit divided by number of years. So first total profit you should find out here. Last 4 years they have given the profit and 1 year loss is there. So first one, total profit. In the first 13 and 14 year, they earn profit 6,000 plus. And they next year incur the loss here. That is 2,000. Sorry, minus beku. Yelli loss agirthitala nimagadra deduct madbeku and profit galanna add madbeku. So here minus is there. And next year they earn profit again. That is 10,000. Again, they last year earn the profit only, that is 12,000. And how many years profit is there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of years are 4 years. So, total madri list madre nodi. 10 plus 12, 22. 22 plus 6, 28. 28 minus 2, that is 26. Divided by 4, that is 6,000. 26,000 divided by 4, it is 6,500. This is the average profit for the year. So, in the next step, calculate the goodwill. Goodwill equals to average profit into number of years of purchases. So, average profit you got here 6,500 into number of years are 3 years here. Number of years is 3 years. So, 6,500 into 3 it is rupees 19,500. So, this is the value of goodwill of the firm here. Goodwill of the firm is last line. Goodwill of the firm equals to rupees 19,500. It should be put into the box. It is the answer what they asked here. Calculate the goodwill is there, no? That is goodwill of the firm is 19,500.